Hi all, this is Macy 4390 Business Intelligence. This is a fresh session that I'm conducting right now. The one that I recorded in the morning somehow lost connection in between, and for quite some time my voice was not, heard. So I'm doing it again. This is today. What we would do is we would discuss the course syllabus for this class. Okay. I'm Dr. Kakoli Bandyopadhyay. Most of you know me as Dr. B. I go by Dr. B because I have a long last name. My office is in room 237 GB. My number is 8808627. You can email me regarding this class, but always use Blackboard email. My Lamar email is for non-class related issues. Okay. Office hours for this course is Tuesday and Thursday, 10 to 11, and I'm available online at, I've given you the URL, so you have to click on that Lamar Acrobat URL and you can come and see me online. Let me tell you how I would be conducting this course throughout the semester. Throughout the semester, I would be available online on Tuesdays and Thursdays from 10 to 11 at that link that I have given you under office hours. I would be lecturing on the chapters that we would cover in this course, five chapters from the book. I would also be available to answer questions on assignments, to explain assignments, to answer any problem that you may be facing, okay, to discuss anything that you would want me to discuss. However, your attendance during that online session is not mandatory. This is an online class, so I understand that you may be working or you may be taking another class at 10. That's fine. I will record each and every session and I will post the video in Blackboard under lecture videos. It would be your responsibility to listen to the video before the next class day. Okay? After listening to the video, if you have questions, you can email me and I would reply back. So, you can come online during at 10 Tuesday and Thursday, and you can interact with me face to face, or you can do it asynchronously. Okay? That means you listen to the video at your own free time and then you ask me questions, which I would reply once I get them. Okay, this is how the course would be conducted. Once again, I will be available online, but it's not mandatory for you to attend the session. If you attend, I will be happy to have you, but if you don't, that's fine. I would expect then for you to listen to the video of the day that I would post in Blackboard. Before you start, it's very important that you explore everything that has been already posted in Blackboard. In Blackboard, under syllabus, you will find my syllabus. Then within the course content, you will find different folders on chapter slides, on chapter study guide, on lecture videos, on assignments, etc. Some of the assignments have already been posted. Okay. You can work on them at their own pace, but late assignments will not be accepted. So due dates have been mentioned and you have to submit the assignments by the due date. Okay, the study guides I have prepared for each chapter, and the study guides basically talks about the topics that we would be covering from that chapter. If you listen to my lecture videos, you will see that I would be covering those topics while I am lecturing on that chapter. Before I get into those details, let me explain to you the course objective. As the title of the course suggests, this course is on business intelligence. What is business intelligence? Business intelligence basically helps us to summarize huge volume of information that an organization has collected. And with that information, what we do is we analyze that information, we analyze that data, find out information, and that information helps us to make decisions. Now, if we make right decisions, with right decisions, we can help improve the performance of the organization. So our goal is to improve the decision making process to help organization perform better, and we do that by having access to huge volumes of data the organization has collected and by learning tools and technologies to be able to analyze that data. Business intelligence is a very current topic. It's a hot topic. The area is growing. Lots of jobs are available in that area because all these organizations are collecting huge volumes of data. Think of Walmart. They collect billions of records of data. What do they do with that data, right? So we need the tools and technologies to be able to analyze that data to find out information that can help us to make better decisions, and decisions will help us to improve our performance. Okay, so in this class, we will learn several useful tools and technologies. First of all, we will learn the SAP Business Information Warehouse module, which is a totally new enterprise software application for business intelligence, analytical reporting and data warehousing. No other class in Lamar campus will teach you the Business Information Warehouse module. It's a, you know, it's a real addition to your knowledge base. Also, we use Tableau. Tableau is a very expensive and a very sophisticated data visualization software. So what are the learning objectives? First of all, you will learn the concepts of BI. You will learn terms such as what is an operational data store, what is a data warehouse, what is a data mart, what are some of the data access tools, okay? Then you will learn also that the data or islands of data, disparate data, disconnected data in an organization does not help. So business intelligence basically helps to coordinate the data into a cohesive enterprise planning system, and that supports the decision making throughout the organization at all levels, in the operational level, in the tactical level, and in the top strategic level also. We will understand the issues with success and failure of BI. Importantly, we will learn a variety of software tools. Okay. We would learn how to design a data warehouse. We will learn how to analyze the data in a data warehouse and with the help of several tools and technologies. Okay. We will also know the emerging trends in BI, and we will learn Tableau. We will learn the business intelligence platform. We will learn data modeling for business intelligence. We will learn SAP data modeling for SAP Business Information Warehouse. This class is almost 90% plus hands-on. Okay, we will learn the theory from the book, and then we will have enough assignments to work on. I think there is an assignment every week which will take you through the process of learning hands-on business intelligence. And I hope that it would add marketability to your resume, because this is a very hot topic. Lots of companies are recruiting. ADA compliance and drop and withdraw dates, please look at the syllabus. The prereq for this class is MESI 3310. Teaching material is Business Intelligence, second edition, Prentice Hall. The book is small. It has 5 chapters, and we would use this book, you know, for the lecture, for the chapter. Resources. Please note the resources. This is very important that you understand the resources that are available to you for this course. First of all, Teradata University Network. Teradata University Network is a site which stores a lot of information about business intelligence. They let you use a free software called MicroStrategy. They give you lots of data files. They give you access to white papers, to you know, videos, and a lot of valuable information about business intelligence. I would like you to register. You have to register as a student. When you get into that site, you have to register as a student. The password would be extreme data. Please register for Teradata University Network. Class notes available in My Blackboard. I would like you to explore My Blackboard, and the Acrobat online conferencing, a link I have given you. You have to click on that link to come and see me. Computer requirements, you know, you need a computer, or you can use Lab 109. SAP client. If you have the client from another semester, that should work. If you do not have SAP client, you can either download it. The easiest way would be to come and pick it up in room 214 GB. Miss Liz Simmons can give you a DVD of the SAP client. For Blackboard problems, you have to contact Distance Ed at 87849 SAP help. You can always get help from me, but Miss Liz Simmons is an additional help, and she's our SAP coordinator. She's very knowledgeable about SAP. She is available to help you Monday through Thursday, 9:30 to 1:30, and Friday from 9:30 to 12:30. Okay, her room number is 214 GB and her phone number is 880-7220. Please remember that Miss Liz Simmons, you can always come to her and get help when things are not working and I'm not available. Okay, remember that lots of help are available. You just need to know how to take that help to be able to finish this class successfully. Academic dishonesty, it's very important that you do your own work. If you submit somebody else's file, immediately I will catch you and you will be penalized. You will receive a zero for that assignment. I may even fail you for the course, so don't do that, okay? Always submit your file only, nobody else's file. You can take help from friends, you can take help from me, you can take help from Lee Simmons, that's fine. But do your own work, don't submit somebody else's work. Recommended software, SAP Business Information Warehouse module, and I will give you the ID and the password to that, and Microsoft Excel, Microsoft Access, and Tableau. Tableau is a very expensive software. It's $1,500 a piece. I would not want you to buy it. I'm talking to Tableau to arrange for free access for a limited time to my students. I'll let you know when I have that access information. There would be two exams. One would be on the book chapters and the another would be on SAP. Assignments would be loaded in Blackboard within the assignment folder well ahead of time. Late assignments will not be accepted. If you have other things to do in that particular day when your assignment is due, please do it earlier. It's already made available, some of them. So pace your time in such a way that you can finish it before time. Another thing I need to mention, that if today is the due date for an assignment, the due time would be 11:59 in the night. If you sit at 11 in the night and if you are stuck with something, you won't get any help. So I insist that you start your assignment one day, minimum one day earlier, so that if you are stuck, you still have a day to ask for help. Grading, exam 1 and 2, 25 points. SAP assignments 150 points, non-SAP assignments 150 points, so total 350 points. Okay, the first day was the introduction session. I had it in the morning, but I lost the video as I was telling you. I recorded, but it didn't have my voice all through. Somehow I lost the connection and lost the voice, so I'm re-recording it. But this is mostly what we discussed today. On Thursday, I will go over Chapter 1, and I will record the lecture. If you can come and attend, that would be wonderful. If you can't make it, that's fine too. I will record the session and I will make it available through Blackboard. And please listen it before January 18. On January 18, you have to work on your Assignment 1, which has already been posted. And on Chapter 2, we would be talking about data warehousing. And then there will be an assignment. Then Chapter 4 is on data mining. Chapter 5 is on text and web mining, and Chapter 3, which we would be doing at the end, is on business performance management. Okay, now by the end of once we come back from spring break, we will start working on SAP, and then for the rest of the semester, we would be working on SAP, and we will have a final exam on May 6, from May 6 to during that period, May 6 to May 8 on SAP. Okay, now a few things I would like you to, internalize. First of all, this is an online class and there are some ways that you need to follow in order to be successful in an online class. Number one, structure. One thing about me, one positive I would say, I may have many negatives that my students would be able to tell you, but one positive about me is that I'm organized and I'm structured. Okay, so this course, I have spent a lot of time in designing this class in such a way that everything is organized and structured and presented to you in a very clear fashion. nothing is vague or nothing is, you know, not clear here. Every assignment is listed, every due date is listed, the study guides have been made available, the different important topics that would be covered would be lectured and, you know, posted. It's very important that you understand where these materials are stored. So I would ask you to spend 20 minutes to 9 in exploring Blackboard. Look at the syllabus. 90% of the questions you ask me are already there in the syllabus. You need to read your syllabus, okay? So read your syllabus. Click on every folder that I have stored in Blackboard. Go to course content. You will see the chapter outlines. You will see the chapter slides. You will see the study guides. You will see the assignments. Click on those folders. Okay. Then look at the due dates. Don't miss an assignment. Start early so that you can get help if you need help. If you start at 10 in the night, then nobody would be there to help you. Okay. So start early so that you can get help. I am here every day. If I'm not teaching a class or if I'm not in a meeting, I'm in my office. So you can call me, you can write to me using Blackboard, or if you don't find me, you can also take help from Liz Simmons. Liz Simmons, she knows SAP. She is a good, you know, SAP coordinator. She has a good knowledge base. You can also take help from her. Take as much help as you want. Don't feel shy in asking for help. Call me. I've given you my phone number. Email me. Go to Liz Simmons. Take help in every possible way. Ask your classmates. You may find them in other classes. Even if this is an online class, you can email them or you can find them in online classes. Most of you are already in my MESI 4380 class. Okay. So you see your friends face to face anyway. Okay. When you see me, you can always ask me questions. But don't leave your question unanswered. That's my point, okay? Find out an answer to your question and don't feel shy to ask questions. Okay, now, other than exploring Blackboard, make sure that you understand that we will use the Teradata University Network for some of the exercises, so register there. Make sure that you have the SAP client handy. You may not need it now, but then if you don't collect it now, maybe when we start SAP, the day before you will figure out that you don't have the SAP GUI. Okay, so collect that SAP client from Ms. Liz Simmons or make sure that you have it in your computer. All the software would be loaded in Lab 109 also. Okay, Tableau, when I get access to Tableau, I will give you the Tableau link. Microsoft Access and Excel, it's in the computer lab. You may have it in your computer also. Okay, so do well in this class. Do as I ask you to do and you should be okay. And ask me for all kinds of help, that's not at all a problem, okay? I will be more than glad to help you. Because, okay, so what I'll do now is I will save this session, I will post the video in Blackboard. After you listen to the video, if you have any questions, feel free to ask me, okay? Email me using Blackboard and I will answer your questions. Okay. All of you have a good semester, work well, and I hope that this job will help you to fetch a job. And by the way, if you are not a member of the MIS Lamar Facebook, please join us. I post all kinds of job information.